somebody who wears glasses and likes to sing. My book is When Adventure Meets Magic, much like The Golden Compass or The Lion and the Witch and the Wardrobe series. So, enjoy. I bet you can't guess who I am. Beyond the footsteps of the greatest explorers and up past the reach of the trustiest maps, there lies a kingdom called Erkenwald. Here, the sun still shines at midnight in the summer, glinting off the icebergs in the north and slipping between the snow-capped Nevercliffs in the west. But it does not rise at all in the long, cold winters. Then, the nights bleed on and the darkness is so thick you cannot see your hands in front of your face. This far north, even the stars do not behave as you might expect. And that is probably just as well, because without Ursa Minor breaking a few rules, we would not have a story at all. The Little Bear, some call this constellation, but if astronomers knew the truth, if they could see into the heart of things and out the other side, perhaps they would have used a different name. For these seven stars are in fact sky gods, mighty giants carved from stardust, and the brightest of them all, the North Star, was the one who first breathed life into Erkenwald. Such was his power that he only needed to blow the legendary frost horn once, and the empty stretches of ice many miles below began to change. Mountains, forests, and glaciers appeared. Then animals arrived. Polar bears to roam the tundra, whales to glide through the oceans, and wolves to stalk between the trees. Finally, the music of the frost horn conjured people, men and women of different shapes, sizes, and colours, scattered throughout the land. As the years passed, these men and women formed three tribes. The Fair Tribe built teepees from caribou hides in a forest to the south of the kingdom. The Feather Tribe settled inside caves in the Nevercliffs to the west. And the Tusk Tribe built igloos amongst the clifftops of the north coast. Each tribe had their own customs and beliefs, but they lived in harmony with one another, sharing food whenever they passed and offering shelter when the weather closed in. Because magic often lingers long after it has been used, the power of the frost horn hovered over Erkenwald, and as time went by, the people learned how to use it. They spun hammocks from moonlight, which granted wonderful dreams. They trapped sunbeams in lanterns, which burned through the winter months. They stored wind inside gemstones, which granted their boats safe passage through stormy seas. And the people knew all was well in their kingdom whenever they saw the northern lights. For these rippling colours were a sign that the sky gods were dancing, and that meant the world was as it should be. But darkness can come to any kingdom, and so it came to Erkenwald. The smallest sky god grew jealous of the North Star's power, and, seeking to rule Erkenwald herself, she pulled away from the constellation one winter night and plunged towards Earth. The North Star acted swiftly and trapped her in a glacier before she could spread her evil across the land. But the sky gods stopped dancing because they knew that it was only a matter of time before someone heard the whispers of the fallen star calling out behind the ice. And before long, someone did.